Hello everyone! In this week's video, I'm redrawing art from my childhood How to Draw Manga books. I started learning how to draw manga when I was about 14 years old. Back then, there weren't a ton of online resources for learning how to draw manga. There were some, but I didn't know about a lot of them because I was a homeschool kid and I pretty much only used the internet to play Disney Channel games like 625's Sandwich Stacker and Coffee Shop on Cool Math Games. Anyways, because there weren't a ton of online tutorials and resources, I learned a lot from how to draw manga books. On Twitter, I saw this tweet kind of suggesting this challenge of drawing this character that's on the cover of a How to Draw Manga book, and I thought it sounded like a really fun idea. So I'll redraw this character in my style. I'll also draw another illustration that is redrawing a picture from my first How to Draw Manga book. So let's get started. Like I said, I'm going to redraw the character that is on the cover of the book How to Draw Manga by Katy Coope. This book was released in 2002, so I was only like 7 at the time. I never owned this book, however, I remember seeing it all over the place when I was looking into How to Draw Manga books. It turns out the artist Katy Coope was only 16 when this book was published. That's really impressive that she was able to get a book published at such a young age. It also looks like she was working with traditional mediums like fineliners and colored pencils. Now that I think about it, maybe I should have redrew this picture of traditional art supplies, but I didn't consider that until now, so it's too late for that. I am working in Clip Studio Paint and I am using a XP Pen Innovator 16 drawing tablet. After doing my rough sketch, I did a cleanup sketch, but I'm not going to make you watch it because my line art process is fairly similar to the cleanup sketch process, so it's almost like watching the same thing twice. Recently, I don't have much motivation to do clean line art. I mean, it's still pretty clean in this video, but I am trying to loosen up a bit. You see, I occasionally get comments like, I don't like how clean her line art is, or don't you think her art would look better if her line art wasn't so clean? And basically just a bunch of different comments of people saying that they don't like how clean my line art is. And I'm kind of starting to feel like, why do I put in the effort of making it clean if people like it better when it's messy? It's like all my extra work is kind of for nothing. But I do get where the comments are coming from. My line art maybe does need to be a little looser to help it feel less stiff. I'm also using a textured brush for the line art in this video to help it feel a bit softer. So yeah, I'm trying to be a little looser and a little softer with the line art to hopefully help it feel less stiff. I have been changing the line art style for my illustrations. I haven't changed the line art for my webcomic at all, because I feel like changing the line art would really change the look of the art for my webcomic. However, I am considering changing it for season 3. Season 2 will be ending in a couple chapters, which I'm excited about. So yeah, I'm thinking about changing up the art style a little bit in season 3. But at the same time, season 3 is the final season, so I'm like, should I just keep it the same to keep everything consistent? I don't really know. For the most part, drawing this boy in my style wasn't too tricky. You know, it's just a boy in 3/4 view. However, his hair was kind of hard to draw. The original is very stylized, so I was having a hard time translating it into my style. A lot of times, I feel like I draw hair in a not super anime way. Like, you know, the super big kind of pointy shapes that go all over the place. I tend to draw it very soft and flowy and kind of more round. So I was trying my best to draw the original hairstyle in my style. It was fun to play around with a different hairstyle that I don't usually draw. After the line art, it's time for the coloring. I feel like it's been a while since I shaded a finished illustration. Well, I guess it hasn't been that long. The last one I did was my new channel icon I drew a few weeks ago, but it still feels like it's been a while for some reason. The character is pretty pale on the cover. Actually, he is like totally white with a little bit of white skin tone for the shadows. Instead of making him just white, I'm going to make him a light skin tone. I actually used my character Brayson's skin tone because he is pretty pale, so I thought it would work well in this case. I usually save the eyes for the last thing I color, but I decided to shade them now for some reason. The reason why I often shade the eyes last is because when I was young, I would struggle with having motivation to finish pictures. So to help motivate myself, I would save my favorite parts for last and work on things I found less fun first. This work process has kind of stuck with me over the years, but now I have YouTube to motivate me to get illustrations done because if I don't finish them in time, I don't have a video for the week, so I need to finish them. I now don't really need to stick with my process of working on things I don't want to work on first, but I often still do that anyways. I like to get the tough stuff out of the way and work on the easier stuff later. Shading the hair was the trickiest part of working on this picture, but it was a lot of fun. Because this video is inspired by how to draw manga books, how about we do a mini hair shading tutorial? So I start by making a new layer and clipping it to my base color layer. I then use the thin gouache brush to apply a lighter blue to the hair. You don't have to use the thin gouache brush, you can use whichever one you like. I just like this one because of how it feels and behaves. So I apply the light blue in the direction the hair is flowing. I add it to wherever I feel like I want the hair to kind of stand out a bit. I make the color separate wherever I feel like the hair is separating. The point of adding this light blue color is to help the hair have a little bit more texture and detail. And it also kind of helps define the shape of the hair. I use a soft eraser and fade out the colors a little bit to help them blend into the rest of the hair. I make a new layer that is clipped to the base layer and set it to multiply. I use a soft brush to apply some shadows by the hair part. I use the blending tool to pull out the color. I make the blue taper out into the hair where the hair is separating. I'll also drag the lighter color into the darker color to add a little bit more detail. I'll use a large airbrush to apply gradients to some areas. Next, it's time for the highlights. I make a new layer that is clipped to the base layer and set it to add glow. I then go around the hair and draw a bunch of tiny strokes to add batches of highlights. To help the hair look round, I often draw the highlights slightly curving. I fade the highlights out with a soft eraser and then lower the opacity. Lastly, I add some gradients set to add glow around the edges to give the hair a little bit of rim light. And ta-da, the hair is shaded. Lastly is just the finishing touches. I added a bunch of different size circles, kind of like the ones on the cover. I also add some gradients to the background and make the circle around the character orange. And here is the finished result. This challenge was very interesting to do, and if you want to join in, you can redraw the cover in your style and use the hashtag #HowToDrawMangaRedraw. This video is sponsored by a new tutorial on WingFox. It's called Level Up Your Digital Painting Skills, Beginner to Advanced. This tutorial is taught by Fisherman. He is a very talented professional senior concept designer with over 8 years of experience in game design, comic books, and game cards and illustrations. This course includes multiple female character illustration cases. You can follow the step of Fisherman to go through the workflow, tips, and skills of each case in detail. You'll also learn about textures and how to make your paintings look like they are made out of real materials. A technique I think is really cool is photo bashing. Fisherman goes in depth on how to take elements of real photos and use them in your concept designs. These are just a small portion of what you learn in this huge 31-hour tutorial. This massive tutorial is currently only $49. Once it's fully released, it'll jump up to its real price of $109. If you're interested in taking this course, the affiliate link is in the description. So now it's time to redraw a picture from my first How to Draw Manga book. My first book was Manga for the Beginner, Everything You Need to Start Drawing Right Away by Christopher Hart. I always feel super nostalgic when I flip through this book. As I was flipping through, one character stuck out to me. The book refers to him as the handsome teenage boy. I remember I wanted all of my boy characters to look like him and I thought he was so cool. I would stare at this and feel kind of sad that I couldn't draw handsome boys like this one. So let's start drawing him. A lot of the male characters I draw are in their mid-teens, however this character always gives me an older teen vibe, maybe like 18 or 19. So I'm drawing him looking a little older and with larger body proportions. To be honest, I was feeling kind of rusty while working on this illustration. I haven't been very good about keeping up with my pose practice drawing sessions. The only full body characters I draw recently are for my webcomic. Working on this made me feel like I need to go back into sketching poses again. For the most part, I was struggling with the feet placement. The rest of it didn't give me too much trouble. You see, I had the book open next to me and I would glance at it to make sure I was keeping things similar to the original. However, his feet kind of don't make sense in the original. Like, if you look at the way his knee is facing, and then if you look at the foot, they are kind of facing in different directions. I was explaining this to my sister, and as I was explaining it, she tried to mimic the leg placement in the book, and she kind of hurt her leg a little bit. She couldn't totally mimic the pose, and she was like, ow, ow, it's hurting my leg. I was trying my best to match the legs to the original, but in the end, I had to draw them in a fairly different position. I did a lot of the foot and leg drawing off camera because it was taking me a while to get it to look okay. After the sketch, it was time for the line art. Once again, I'm using a textured pen for the line art. Another difference between mine and the original is that I drew my clothes not as large and baggy. The art in the book has the clothes be fairly stylized and very large in proportion. I decided to make the clothing not as large. They are a bit baggy, but the overall proportion compared to the character is a little closer to something you would see in real life. Sometimes when I'm online, I'll see discussions about how to draw manga books and if they do more harm than good. I think for beginners, how to draw manga books are very helpful. Like, when I started drawing, I knew nothing. I didn't know how to break things up into shapes, or what guidelines to draw and use, or why we need them. I didn't see the importance of doing a sketch before going into the details. And how to draw books really helped me learn a lot about those basic concepts and fundamentals of drawing. After I got my first how to draw book, my art level increased a lot because I started to understand how the art process worked. I started to be able to break things up into shapes and sketch and kind of do more of the art process. Am I saying if you get this book, you will draw like me? No, I am not. How I draw now is basically a combination of how to draw books, YouTube videos, and my own personal study and practice. I think it's important that when you are learning how to draw, to learn from many different sources. You should learn how different artists work and draw things. Everyone has their own process and their own ways of doing things. And if you learn from many different sources, you can find ways that you like and what works for you. Nowadays, there are so many tutorials on YouTube that kind of feels like how to draw books aren't as necessary. But I still feel like they can be a really nice resource, and it can be nice to have a book next to you that you can just kind of flip through and reference. And some artists have some really nice how to draw books. So after finishing the line art and base colors, I noticed that the line art in the book had a background, so I needed to add one in. I started by making the little brick wall. I used to find bricks very confusing, but they are actually pretty simple. I draw a bunch of horizontal lines and then break up one section into separate bricks. Then on the next row, I just put vertical lines in the middle of the bricks that I put in the other row, and then repeat the process for the rest of the wall. Later on, I add some line variation to help it feel a little bit more organic. For the tile on the ground, I kept trying to make my own round pattern to apply to the ground. I made a black square and then a bunch of different brown circle shapes. After I did that, I took the pattern and squished it down to make it look like it was in perspective. I kept trying to make this work, like I tried for about 45 minutes, but I couldn't get something I didn't hate. So I used a tile pattern from Clip Studio. I probably could have drawn a simple tile pattern, but I was starting to feel lazy at this point, so I just used one from Clip Studio. Lastly, I use a tree brush to make bushes in the background. I take a pencil brush to give it a bit of texture and make it feel more leafy, and then I fade out the edges with the color white to kind of make it mimic the how to draw book. Now that the background is in place, we can move on to the coloring. Since we covered the hair shading with the previous picture, how about I show you how I shade the clothing wrinkles of the shirt? I start by taking a brush and applying my shadow color all around the shirt for where I think the wrinkles are making shadows. I do this very roughly, and don't worry too much about the shape right now. I'm just kind of trying to get an idea of where the shadows need to be. I wish I could fully explain this process, but I'm kind of just following my instincts and thinking about what makes sense. I highly recommend looking at references. They are very helpful for learning how fabric folds and behaves. After I apply the shadows in a very simple manner, I go in with a blending tool to blend out the shading. When blending colors, I like to keep in mind soft edges and hard edges. If I want the fold to fade out and feel kind of rounder, I'll make the edge softer. But if I want it to have an edge and not fade out, I'll make it have a harder edge. A lot of times for folds, on one side is soft and the other is hard. When blending out colors, I often think about how the fabric is bumping out and going back in. I keep in mind that if the cloth is bumping out, it also needs areas where it's going back into the fabric, unless that entire area is bumping out. I'm not sure if that makes sense. Basically, just try to think about how it's bumping in and bumping out and bumping in and bumping out, and how it kind of all interweaves together. After applying the shadows, I'll go in with a slightly lighter color to help make things pop, especially areas of the fabric that go outwards. It was a lot of fun looking back at my old How to Draw books and seeing what inspired me and what I wanted to draw like. It's also kind of neat to see the direction my art has taken. There are so many things that have inspired me over the years, and all of those things come together to make my current style. However, my style will always keep changing and evolving depending on my tastes and what I want to draw. If you look at my webcomic, you can definitely see how my style has changed over the years. I have many more How to Draw books in my book collection, so if you'd like to see me do this again, you can let me know. It was a lot of fun, so I'd be happy to do it again. And here is the finished piece. Do you think he looks like a handsome teenage boy? I always have a hard time telling if my own characters are handsome or attractive because I drew them. But I hope he looks cool and I would make younger me proud. Thank you so much to my beautiful, lovely patrons for helping support this channel. It means so much to me. If you'd like to be on this list with these wonderful people, consider checking out my Patreon page. So that is all for this video. Thank you all so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed it, and I'll see you all next week in my next video. Bye!